That is a seriously delicious piece of fish right there. Oh, that's a fleshy crab. I managed to ferret all this meat out of that crab. Hi folks, we're in Gandhinagar today in Bengaluru and we're going to be tasting some seafood. More specifically, Konkani style seafood. I'm here to dine at Hotel Fishland, a restaurant that's been around for the last 38 years, in which time it's managed to carve out a niche for its Konkani style seafood thali. It's been a few years since I've dined here. Let's go in and find out if the seafood is still as special. Let's go. As you ascend the staircase and arrive at the first floor, you have two doors. One leads to Status AC Restaurant, which is part of the same group, but this is the air-conditioned version, which also has a bar attached. And then you have Fishland, which is popular for its thali. So if you want to do the seafood thali, head to Fishland. That's where we are headed. You know, as you step into Hotel Fishland, it's like stepping back in time. That's the sense, that's the feeling, that's the aura that one gets from the space. But the good thing is that not only do establishments like these transport you back in time, but they also transport you back to some great food from those times. And that's what I'm looking forward to tasting here at Hotel Fishland. So I'm with Mr. Vasudev Desai, who is the owner of Hotel Fishland. So, eshtu varsha idu idu start maadi nindu?
38
years.
1982
in the. So, what is the reason why it's so famous even till
then? They give good food. Fish curry, rice and fry, samma fry, potato fry, kana fry.
Okay. And this is all Konkani style?
Yeah, Konkani. Totally Konkani and South Canara.
So, let's go in and look at some of the fish that's being cooked here at Fishland. So all the thalis are getting lined up here. So today also happens to be a bandh here in Karnataka. That's why it's not as crowded. But on a given day, if you were to come here at 1:30, 1:45, the place would be crowded. That's the real deal here, the fish fry. Fresh sea prawns.
Yes.
Cultured prawns are used. You know, that's the good thing about places like these. They only use the good stuff. So the prawns that you have here are the fresh sea prawns. There's no cultivated farm prawns here. These are the fresh prawns. These are bangude. Look at the size of that mackerel. That mackerel is glistening away. Kingfish. This is bolinjir. Bolinjir. This is my favorite fish. This is the sort of fish that you can eat whole with the bone and everything. Just eat this fish with some ganji. That's the kind of fish that this is. Amile kane. There's some fish getting fried, some mackerel getting fried here. He's coating that mackerel with that chiroti rava, which is basically a combination of the rava and the rice rava. He's making sure that he gets enough of that crumbing onto that fish. Sir, ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ರೆಸಿಪೀಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ನಿಮ್ದ ಮನೆಯಿಂದ. ಸೊ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಇದು ಫಿಶ್ ಫ್ರೈ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಹತ್ರ ಬಹಳ ಫೇಮಸ್ ಇದೆ. ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಮೇನ್ ಇಂಗ್ರೀಡಿಯಂಟ್? ಮಸಾಲಾ. ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಗೋ ಇನ್ ಟು ಇಟ್? ಚಿಲ್ಲಿ, ಟರ್ಮರಿಕ್. ಏನ್ ಚಿಲ್ಲಿ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಾ? ಬ್ಯಾಡಗಿ ಚಿಲ್ಲಿ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಕಲರ್ ಇದೆ. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ವಾಚಿಂಗ್ ಫಿಶ್ ಬೀಂಗ್ ಫ್ರೈಡ್. ಐ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಗಾಟ್ ದ ಜ್ಯೂಸಿಸ್ ಫ್ಲೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಮೈ ಮೌತ್. ವೆನ್ ಯು ಸೀ ಸೀಫುಡ್ kept like this with the masala, with that marinade, kept ready to fry, you know these guys are confident about selling all these fish fries. That's how popular Fishland is. So what is in the thali today? So this is a regular thali or a special thali?
Regular. Special means that fry.
Oh, special gets fries. What fish is this?
Kane.
And you get one rasam. No sol kadi. Why no sol kadi, sir? Konkani restaurant.
It won't go
here. It won't go. I come looking for sol kadi though. Konkani food. And of course there's some vegetable, onion
every day.
And if you order for a special thali, you also get some fried fish. Having looked at all that fish getting fried, all that fish waiting to be fried and that seafood thali, I can't wait to get my meal started here at Fishland. So they're very focused on the food that they do here, which is basically Konkani and South Canara. So of course the main attraction here is the seafood thali. So you've got a limited seafood thali, which is at 190 rupees. And you have a special seafood thali, which I'm told includes one fry as well. And then you have a chicken thali, the fish biryani, and you've got a whole bunch of other fish and prawn dishes. So let's see what's on offer here. Sir, ninge ondu special seafood thali kodi. So give me one prawn fry, one marvai sukka, crab masala kodi. Amale ondu bangude try madana. Tawa fry kodi. So we've got a thali here, the seafood thali. So what does the seafood thali have? The seafood thali has some rice. You have the option of a white rice or the boiled rice. I chose a boiled rice. I think there's more flavor in this and there's also more wellness in this. It's a noisy restaurant to say the least because it's low ceiling, so the sound reverberates and echoes. So I think this is going to be a noisy video of sorts. You've got some buttermilk. You've got some fish curry. The fish curry is the kana fish curry. Not the finest specimen size-wise, but I'm hoping that the flavor in this fish curry makes up for the fact that the kana is not too big when it comes to the size. And then you have the rasam. Personally, I was expecting a sole curry because given this restaurant's Konkani lineage, but they do a rasam. I'm told the rasam is what's more popular. And then of course you have some curd, a smidgen of a vegetable, which I think is a beetroot here, some pickle. Not to forget, we ordered the special thali, which comes with a piece of kingfish. This is a weighty piece of fish. And then we have our other side dishes. So we've got the mackerel here, a bangude, which is a fry, a tawa fry. We have some shellfish, some marvai, which is made in a sukka. And then you have the prawn masala fry as well. And then you have the crab. This is the sea crab, the denji as they call it in South Canara. And I think I'm going to begin my meal with the fish fry, the kingfish fry. You can see that masala naped that fish. It's been sitting here for a few minutes, but it's still steaming away a wee bit. You got a thick slice of the fish, of the kingfish, naped in that masala. And then crumbed with that rice flour and that semolina. Looking forward to tasting this here. I think that masala is spot on. I would have expected the fish to be a little more flaky, which it isn't. So it's a little tough on the bite. I think this fish may benefit from a drizzle of lime. The fish was great in terms of the crumbly texture and also some of that masala, but personally, was it the best kingfish that I've tasted? Perhaps not. But I'm hoping that this bangude here will redeem the reputation of this establishment. This is the mackerel tawa fry. That is a seriously delicious piece of fish right there. That mackerel is fresh. You can see that from its pristine white flesh. It's naped in that beautiful masala. That masala is a secret sauce here at Fishland. You can taste the heat of the chili, the tang of the tamarind that goes into that masala. So it's a combination of hot and sour. This is a delicious bangude fry. I think the crumbing of the rava also subdues that masala a wee bit. So you're not really tasting that masala in all its effusive glory as you taste in this tawa masala fry. Oh, this is delicious. Give me one of this along with some rice and a fish curry. That's all that you need. That fish is fried perfectly on the tawa. So it's got a nice crusty surface and it's got the flaky meat of the fish that it holds with. This is fried to textbook perfection. I think we're going to stay with the masala and go for that prawn masala. These are the sea prawns. These are not the cultured prawns, the medium-sized prawns. You can taste the sweetness of the prawn through that masala. Oh, this is a delicious prawn. So the prawn is cooked just right. It's naped in all that masala and then cooked on a tawa on one side till it forms that masala crust. And that's what makes it delicious. So that prawn is firm, springy and yielding. It's not turned into a mush, it's not pasty at all. This is prawn that is at its freshest and cooked just so well in that masala. That masala is delicious. I want to taste that prawn now with a bit of the lime. I love the way the masala is naping this prawn. So you got the masala on one side and you got the lemon on the other side. The prawn, the etti and the mackerel, the bangude, have more than made up for my initial wee bit of a disappointment with the kingfish fry. I think next it's time to taste the sukka, the marvai sukka, the shells, the clams. You know, you really need to love your marvai to make the effort to get at the meat, because the meat is very limited. I mean, you've got this teeny weeny portion of the meat and then naped in that masala. It's a tasty dish, but not a dish that made an impression like the prawns and the mackerel. I find that the clam is a bit wanting in its flavor. All that you taste is that masala, and the clam barely makes its presence felt. I want to taste the clam just by itself. The tiny clam. The clam is definitely wanting in its flavors. I think on that note, I'm going to get to the curries here. And we're going to make a beginning with the kana curry or the ladyfish. Mix that curry nicely into that rice. I want to taste the curry even before I taste the fish. That's a comforting curry. There's a bit of heat from the chili. There's a saar that's perhaps from the tamarind and the kokum. It's a sort of curry that makes for a comforting partner to this boiled rice. Let's taste the fish now, the kana. This is a small size kana, and I'm told that the fish here in the fish thali changes on a daily basis depending on what's available. So today they have the kana fish curry. That kana, that fish has soaked all that flavor of that curry. You know that this fish has been sitting in that curry for a while. It's not a jhatka curry, this is a curry that's made and then kept. So I guess when the curry for the day is over, the thali is also over, because they only made those many portions of the curry that goes into the thali. You know, I think the kana is one of the most delicately flavored fish. It's quite mellow in its flavors, and the fish has a certain sweetness to it. I love this. If you don't eat kana too often, just be a little careful of the tiny bones. But they're the sort of bones that you can literally swallow without any worries. You know, this is a deep flavored fish curry. This fish has been cooked in that fish curry, has been sitting in that fish curry for some time, and therefore has absorbed all the flavors of the curry. So you've got that gentle heat, you've got the tartness that comes from the tamarind, from the kokum, and all that you taste in this piece of fish. Delicious. I think I'm going to go for my vegetables. This is the formality of a vegetable that you have here on a thali. So even if you don't eat it, you'd be forgiven because you can barely notice it. This is a vegetable for the day made of beetroot. A tasty vegetable. So if you want to get some fiber in the midst of all that seafood, go for some of that beetroot palya. It's got the coconut, it's got some mustard seeds, it's got some chili. Actually, it makes for a tasty bite. I think next we're going to go for the denji, the crabs, the sea crabs here, the sea crab curry. And I'm going to go for it with some of that rice. So just get a bit of the rice and then get some of that crab onto my plate. I don't think you can ferret out this crab with the spoon. So I want some of that crab. That crab is dripping away all those juices of that curry. I think the curry looks very similar to that fish curry. So I suppose the base for the curry is the same. So let's dig into some of that crab here. Oh, that's a fleshy crab. I managed to ferret all this meat out of that crab. I love that sweet flavor of that crab. Oh, this crab is delicious. Look at all that meat. It's got that briny sweetness that you taste in that sea crab. This is a crab that's quite generous in the amount of meat that's contained within it. Also bite into that shell and chew on that crab goodness. It may look a bit gross, but there's nothing called being polite or being mindful when it comes to eating crab. You know, if you want to enjoy your crab, you got to go for it unabashedly, without any hesitation. Because that's the only way you'll enjoy the goodness of that crab. All that delicious meat. And that meat has soaked up the flavor of that curry. This is delicious. When you're eating crab, you got to eat fursat mein. No hurries, no rush. Just spend your time with the crab. Try to understand what's happening, what's going on with this crab, even as you devour it. I think I'm going to go for one of these claws. You got to peel away at the bone to reveal all that meat. All that meat and that crab claw. That's delicious. When it comes to crab, you got to go in with both your hands. If you need one reason to come to Fishland, this crab masala would be it. I think I got a wee bit distracted there with the crab. Let's get back to tasting some of the other dishes here on my thali, including some of the crab curry with that rice. That crab curry has also soaked up the sweetness of that crab. That's what I'm tasting in that crab curry. Oh, that's delicious. I think I'm going to go back to that bangude, that delicious mackerel fry. I love the way the fish has been roasted. It's made that masala kadak. The masala is firm to the touch on that fish. I'm going to taste that mackerel now just with that rice. Get some of that masala, a piece of the fish and the rice. I know this is going to make for a great combination even before I eat it. That's a look of happiness. That mackerel and that denji, the crab. And not to forget, the prawns. I love that fresh sweetness of the prawn, the fresh prawns. Cultured prawns, farm prawns can come nowhere close to the flavors that you get from fresh sea prawns. This is delicious. And if you think you've got a bit of a seafood overload, you can reach for that rasam. And dive back into the curry. I think a meal here is really about the fish curry and the fries. The last of my kana, that tiny kana. I think when it comes to the curry that's given along with the thali, I think the size of the fish is a bit tiny. This is perhaps the tiniest kana that I've ever eaten, but it's tasty nonetheless. And I can't resist from going for one more of that prawn. The prawn and that fish curry. I think as we come to the end of our meal here, I think I should get some of the rice and a bit of that curd. Maybe some pickle, some uppinakaya. Make a morsel of the rice, the curd and some of that pickle. I think what will make that curd rice even more interesting is to get one of this prawn and the masala into my next bite. The prawns are delicious, but the combination does taste a little weird because you've got that intense acidity, the sourness of that curd and the masala kick of that prawn. Well, I've enjoyed my meal here at Hotel Fishland. I've enjoyed some of the dishes more than the others. For instance, I love that crab masala, that crab curry. The fish curry too was special, and so was the prawn fry. But I think the piece de resistance here, the most special dish here was that mackerel fry, that bangude fry. So if I were to come here the next time, I don't think I would order for the fish thali. Instead, I would order for the curries, the fries and just some rice, because I think that's the way to savor your meal here at Hotel Fishland. Until the next episode of Gourmet on the Road, stay safe and happy eating. Back to the prawn. If you'd like to support the work that we do at Food Lovers TV, do consider joining our membership community on YouTube by hitting the join button below or on the home page. You could pledge a nominal sum and receive special privileges like behind the scenes footage, shoot updates, access to live Q&As and a lot more. You could support us on a Patreon page as well. For more info, check out the links in the description below. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe, like, share and leave a comment below. Happy eating!